Hey there guys, I'm back to another game review. Today I'll be talking about Telltale's Batman, The Enemy Within on PC. Batman The Enemy Within is a sequel to Telltale's previous Batman season. I played the first season during the Christmas of 2016. I was extremely surprised at the experience I received from that first season. It took the original Batman story, but added a couple of changes to make it Telltale's very own. I honestly loved what Telltale did with Batman. It took a very different approach to Batman's origin story, but at the same time being very good. Also, they utilized a lot of B-tier villains in my opinion, but still made them good antagonists. Lastly, they made Batman's alter ego, Bruce Wayne, a major part of their game and succeeded in the execution. So, when they announced a sequel to one of my favorite Telltale series ever, you know I was damn excited. I chose not to purchase the season pass and play the game as episodes came out because I didn't have money at the time. Also, I knew that the game was going to be on the next big Steam sale, which it was. So I just waited for that sale and just purchased it then. So with all 5 episodes under my belt, what do I think about The Enemy Within? No spoilers, of course, so let's dive right into it. Getting into the story, the game takes place 1 year after the events of the first game. Bruce Wayne is still fighting off crime to keep civilians in Gotham safe. There's a new threat on the horizon though, and Bruce Wayne and Batman are the only ones equipped to stop them. This new threat contains a lot more A-tier villains in my opinion, such as the Riddler and Harley Quinn. Without going into further spoiler territory, the story this time around was great. Telltale really did hit home on playing as Bruce Wayne and Batman within this season. Playing both sides of the mask is extremely important for the plot's progression, and you see how both sides of the mask conflict with Bruce's life. Sort of in the vein of Spider-Man almost, how Peter Parker has to balance between being a normal high schooler and being a superhero. Obviously, this is Batman we're talking about, so it is a little bit different, but you can see my point. Not just the cast of villains were good, but also the supporting cast. I could see why some people may see these characters as annoying or distasteful, but I understood where they were coming from. Overall, the story and decisions Telltale forced you to make within this game were once again amazing. Taking the characters of Batman's world and tweaking them oh so slightly to make them different for Telltale's story was fantastic. I'm curious as to when or if we'll get a third season, because there is definitely more stories to tell here. The gameplay is still very similar to previous Telltale games. Decision making and quick time events are the two main focal points of their games. The decisions to be made in this game were really difficult at times, so difficult I would sometimes not pick a decision because the timer would run out, which has never happened to me in any previous Telltale game I've played. I was almost never fully sold on one decision over another. I was constantly battling with myself with what decision seemed right. The QTEs in this game were fine, I guess. After playing Detroit Become Human, where the QTEs actually matter and messing them up as a simple pressing the wrong button, you don't really get punished in this game for pressing the wrong button. Like, if it says press Q and you happen to press E, you could still press Q in the QuickTime event. Telltale's QTEs, I guess, are a matter of timing, like taking too long will mess it up, but they give you plenty of time to react to the event on screen. Another problem I have with this game were the checkpoints. At certain points of the game, you can happen to die. Where you respawn, however, can mess you up a little. Like, you have to go and talk, or you don't necessarily have to, but you talk to all of these supporting characters around you to go and get an idea as to where they're coming from and get more backstory on them, and then you die. And now you have to go back through those conversations with those characters just to go and make sure that, you know, by having those conversations, you open up possible choices in the future for you to make. And there's no skip button when you have to redo these choices. It's almost like the game doesn't know that you already did this. So if you happen to die, you might have to do this again. Now, this was a small portion of my playthrough, mind you, but I thought I'd mention it anyways. Lastly, the presentation was just spot on. The graphics, the voice acting, the music, all done really well. I can't really pinpoint any tragic problems I have with the presentation overall. So yeah, the presentation was really spot on. So what is my final verdict on Telltale's Batman, The Enemy Within? This is definitely a sequel to their first season, where Telltale changes certain elements of characters to make their story of Batman more interesting. Not to say that in a bad way, I really enjoyed my time with The Enemy Within. It's better than the first season in my opinion, without a doubt. The overarching story was more interesting, the cast of characters this time around was more recognizable, and the decision making in this game was great. If you weren't a fan of the first season, you probably won't like this season either. But if you like the first season like me, you'll probably have a great time with The Enemy Within. Over the 5 episodes, the game is around 9 to 10 hours, which each episode is over 1 hour, but it's never over 2. The game is priced at $24.99 on Steam, which is a little steep for me in my opinion. I'd rather wait for another big Steam sale or just go on a website like Kinguin and get it cheaper now. For consoles, it's $29.99, which... yeah, that is $6 an episode. Whichever platform you decide to play The Enemy Within on, it's a real treat, especially if you enjoyed the first season. Probably my favorite Telltale season to date. Batman The Enemy Within is definitely worth your time and money.